Just jump right in. So for the graphics, we're going to start off. You're going to want full screen exclusive if you can. That's going to be best for your frame rates. I use borderless because I stream and I have multiple screens. Obviously, you're going to pick your graphics card and not your Intel. Your frame rates, you can put on, you're going to want to put on your highest. Mine's on auto, but it's going to be a highest 240. Display resolution, you're going to want to pick whatever your highest is if you want. But if you want higher frame rates, you can pick, 1080p, sorry. So that's what you're going to give you your best frame rates if you want. But if you want better quality, just go ahead and do at 1440. See, shaders, doesn't matter. Display 2.2, that's just normal. Mouse to game window, I have that off. You're going to want NVIDIA Reflex low latency on and boost. I have this on custom. ECU mode preset is custom. We're going to have VSync is off. VSync menu off. Custom frame rates limited. Rate limit. Sorry. You put that on unlimited. You can customize if you want, but I have it on unlimited. Oops. Menu render resolution. I put optimal. Pause game rendering. I have off. Focus mode at 0. And then put this on. You can turn it off if you want to. It's up, really up to you. Then we have quality. Obviously, this is going to be considered custom because I changed everything. So for this is going to be best for higher frame rates. So we're going to put this at 100 at your render resolution at 100. So, and then I do not know how to pronounce this. Fidelity FX and cast, that's what you're going to choose over in NVIDIA DLSS. That's what everyone's using, and it seems to get the best frame rates. We're going to put this, the cache strength, at 90. We're going to put our VSync scale target at 90. Verbal rate shading is on. I thought I had that off. This editing requires, I just turn it on. I have it on. NVIDIA, this is right here, is only for 40 series and up. Well, there's only 40 series. So if it, when 50 series comes, it'll have this. NVIDIA DLSS frame generation, you're going to want that off. It causes a lot of tearing. All right, so detail texture. We're going to go very low on the texture resolution. We're going to go texture filter. We're going to put it on low. Depth of field, we're going to do off. Detail quality levels, we're going to put on low. I do not know how to pronounce that, sorry. We're going to put this on very low. Then bullet impact is pretty much up to you. It doesn't do anything against your frame rates or graphics card. It just shows bullets or not. So that's up to you. I like them on. The effects you can turn off. Shader quality, low. On-demand textures streaming, optimized. Local texture streaming quality, put on low. Shade and light lighting. We're going to put very first one, shadow quality, we're going to put on very low. Then off, 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 low. Now, environment. We're going to do off, low, off, off, off. And this is going to give you the best frame rate, your highest frame rates. So it's obviously going to lower your quality, but it does not look that bad. You're still going to have good quality visually. For view, we're going to put field of view at 120. ADS field of view affected. Then we're going to do weapon field of view wide. These don't really matter. That's really up to you. On camera, world motion blur off, weapon blur off, film grain, put it at zero. First person camera movement, less than 50. Third person, less than 50. These really don't matter. That is for your graphics. That's the best settings for frame rates. Now, let's do controller. For you people that use controller, I do use controller and mouse and keyboard, so I switch back and forth. So, edit, I have on, the preset is tactical. That's what I use. All right. So, bumper ping I have off. Flip off. Stick layout default. And then we go aiming. I have my horizontal and vertical sensitivity at 7. ADS sensitivity at 0.70. Now, no, it's not this one. Vertical aim. That's all the same. All right. So aim response curve, I put standard. Now, ADS multiplier focus is 0.75. Sensitivity transition timing, instant. Custom sensitivity pro is off. You don't need that on. Target aim assist, you're gonna want that on if you want your aim assist. I use default, seems to be one that works the best out of all the ones I've tried. Third person ADS correction assist, we don't even use third person, I don't at least. Motion sensor blur off. Now gameplay. I turn on your automatic tactical sprint. Slide mount instant or slide maintain sprint on. Auto move forward off. Tactical sprint behavior, put on single tap. Ground mantle, you have that on. Automatic airborne mantle, partial. Automatic ground mantle and hang off. And then slide behavior, slide only. This is up to you. I've seen a lot of people using hybrid. They seem to like it. But I prefer slide only. Plunging underneath water. Or underwater, sorry. Put it on free. Parachute automatic behavior. If you want to get down to the ground faster, you're going to want this off. If you don't want to break your legs every single time, turn it on. Up to you. Sprint through doors bash is on. Large climb behavior, mantle only. Aim down side behavior, hold. Chain zoom is sprint, tactical sprint focus. I don't think I've ever changed any of these. These are pretty much what you want to do, to be honest with you. Most people don't change these things. So that's for your controller. Now we're going to have mouse and keyboard. I don't really mess with the sensitivity. Only because I have a mouse that I can already adjust to it. So I don't really mess with this. Keybinds. I don't really mess with mine. I just, they're just standards. But on my mouse that I have, I can show you that most of my stuff are keybinds are on my mouse. So if you look at this right here, this is my keys, my mouse setup. So on the scroller, I have right, which is control, which is, I believe, is reload. And then on the other side, if I was click left, it's R. So I have all these on my key on my mouse, so I don't really change much. It's all connected to my mouse. So gameplay, crouch behavior, I have toggle. Prone behavior, I have toggle. Automatic sprint, you want automatic tactical sprint. Slide sprint is on. Tactical sprint behavior is single tap sprint. Close backpack is on. On sprint is on. Walk behavior hold. Automatic airborne mantle I have off. And the ground mantle hang I have off. Ground mantle. Grounded mantle I have on. Slide dive action I have independent. This is a little bit more important for like when you have your mouse settings with crouching. For like instance, I have my mouse button right here on the back end, which does laying down. So it's because it's independent, it separates the sliding from laying crouch. So now I'm able to lay down, or I can use a different button to slide. So the two different buttons that help with the drop shots. Am I good at it? No, but I'm practicing. Parachute automatic behavior is off, just like on controller. Aim down sight behavior is hold. Focus behavior is toggle. I like to do toggle, not hold. It's a lot easier and less pressure on your hands. That's just me, preference wise. You can do hold if it's easier for you, but for me, it's a lot easier just to push the button and forget about it. Weapon mount active toggle. I have toggle, not hold. Toggle just, you want to, it's a lot easier just push the button on all of them. I have on, so you're going to put, what is this? Deplete ammo weapons. Oh, I have this on, so when you run out of ammo, I just turn it on. Kind of helps out when you run out of ammo and you're in a fight. Let's see, none of this stuff is tactical stance is ADS melee. Tactical stance behavior is on toggle. Armor plate I have on for all of them instead of just doing one at a time. Quick C4, that's just up to you. I have group though. Let's see, vehicle behavior, I don't, that just leaves all that normal. Overlay behavior, this is all normal. Now for audio, I use my PC speaker, and then speaker headphones, I use my system, which I have a Gold XLR. I use default Windows default, and then my max volume because I have some, I'll show you in a second, but since it's so high loud in my headphones, let's see if I can show you here. We'll go here, you go to settings here. Okay, system sound, we're gonna go all the way down to more sound settings. Now what you're gonna do on here is you're gonna find what your main sound system, which is my Gold XLR. You're gonna right click it, go to properties, and then go to enhancement. Now right here in this little box right here, loudness equalization, you're gonna click it and then go to settings, and then there you go, settings, there you go. And now you're gonna release time and put it on short. This is gonna help you hear footsteps a lot better and clearer. And then you just push okay, apply, okay. Now this is the reason why I put it on my master volume at 14, because it's so loud once you put that on. It enhances the loudness and enhances all the sound, so that it makes it a lot easier to hear footsteps. Now that's a PC hack. Not everyone's gonna like that you do that, but hey, it's what we can do. All right, so gameplay music I have completely off. The volume at 20. Dialogue volume is at 20. Effects volume at 100, because that's where it's gonna help you hear the footsteps. Cinematic music I off. War track off. Now The chat volume, that's up to you, depending on how loud you want your chat. Voice chat, I have on. All lobbies. Last word, I have it off. That's up to you. It's, I mean, it is what it is. I have proximity chat on. That's obviously your preference. I do have it on push to talk because I have proximity chat on. I use push to talk because if I don't have push to talk on, they can hear me whenever I just talk. And since I stream and I talk to the chat, they'll be able to hear wherever I'm at. Now, because I haven't push to talk, they can't hear anything, but I can hear them if they're talking. So that's a good one to have on. Microphone level, that's up to you. This is all, don't turn on mono, please. Leave mono off, because if you put on mono, both earphones are being connected and you won't really hear the footsteps as good, because it, depending on your type of headphones you have, like on mine, I can hear it from the left or right, which would identify where they are. But if I put on mono, it's literally going to be in both ears. So it wouldn't make sense. Reduce time sounds. This all right here is just preference. Now, that is it for all the graphics and controller and mouse and keyboard settings. Now, the settings, if you don't have to pick these settings for the controller or mouse and keyboard. It's all preference to you and how you want to run them. But this is what you can get the best movement for either controller or for mouse and keyboard. If you want to be a movement god, use these controls. For the graphics, like I said, if you want the high frame rates, the highest that you can get, follow each step because you'll get the best frame rates that you want. Other than that, if you like this information, if this information helped you, go ahead, hit that like and subscribe, and have a wonderful day.